You invest time and resources in creating compelling ads that capture user interest. But what happens after the click? The destination your ad leads to is just as critical as the ad itself. The destination requirements policy is designed to ensure that the journey from your ad to your landing page is seamless, positive, and trustworthy. Google prioritizes a safe and trustworthy ad network for all users. Google requires your ad's destination to be functional on common browsers and devices. This means no error pages like site under construction, whoops, nothing to see here, or HTTP errors such as a 403, 404, or 500 error. To fix this, double-check the URL for typos. Ensure your server is configured correctly and, if needed, work with your web developer to resolve any server-side errors. Your ads must accurately reflect the app or website users are directed to. The display URL shown in the ad needs to match the final URL. For instance, if your display URL is google.com but the final URL takes users to example.com, that's a mismatch. Redirects from the final URL to a completely different domain are also problematic. Destination not crawlable means Google AdsBot web crawlers can't access your landing page content. Google AdsBot needs to crawl your page to ensure it aligns with the ad. This often happens if your robots.txt file restricts access to your entire site or large parts of it. Sometimes, unintentionally limiting crawl capacity, especially after submitting many ads, can also cause this. Review your robots.txt file and server settings to ensure Google AdsBot isn't blocked. You can use Google Search Console to check for crawl errors. Your ad destinations must be accessible in the targeted location. If users in the region you're advertising to see messages like, "This site is not accessible in your location," or "You do not have permission to access this page," that's a violation. So if you're targeting Canada, users in Canada should be able to view your landing page without issue. Landing pages should be safe and easy to navigate, without frustrating elements. Avoid things like excessive pop-ups or interstitials that block content, disabling the browser's back button, or links that initiate direct downloads of files, except for pharma PDF landing pages. Abusive experiences, like auto-redirects or ads mimicking system warning, would lead to ad disapproval. Your ad experiences should also conform to the Better Ad standards. This means no prestigious ads with countdowns or large, flashing, sticky ads. Insufficient original content violations occur when ad destinations don't offer unique value. We want users to find useful, original information. This includes sites designed primarily to show ads, content replicated from other sources without adding value, like scraped content or simple templates, or parked domains showing under construction. Focus on providing unique, useful content immediately on the landing page. Avoid overloading it with ads and ensure it's not just a gateway to another site. If your ad leads to an app or an item in a web store like the Chrome Web Store or Google Play Store, that destination must comply with the store's own policies. To fix this, you'll need to resolve the issue with the app or web store directly. URLs must follow standard syntax. Using an IP address as the display URL, like 123.456, or unacceptable characters such as exclamation mark, asterisk, or hash in your display URL will lead to an unacceptable URL disapproval. Ensure your URLs are correctly formatted and use valid characters. An unrecognized app issue occurs if Google can't identify the app your ad is promoting. This could be due to a malformed app ID, an incorrect app store listed, or if the app has been deleted or suspended from its store. Double-check your app ID and ensure the app is active and correctly listed in the relevant app store. If you're using phone numbers in call-only ads, call assets, or location assets, they must be verified. An unverified phone number means Google couldn't confirm it. To verify, the number should be present as text on your website, on the same domain as your ad's display URL. You can also verify by linking your Google Search Console and Google Ads accounts, or by adding a Google Ads tracking tag to your site. Even if verified, some phone numbers are unacceptable. This includes fax numbers, premium numbers, or vanity numbers where letters replace digits. Phone numbers must be local or domestic for the country you're targeting, and typically shouldn't be virtual phone services or personal numbering in most regions. And ensure there's an active voicemail service. If you need to see how Google AdsBot views your page, especially for destination not working or not crawlable issues, you can use Chrome DevTools to override your browser's user agent and mimic our crawlers. Google uses different AdsBot user agents for mobile and desktop, so testing with these can be very helpful. For more detailed information on how to fix any issues, please visit support.google.com.